One of the most time-consuming steps in a correlational meta-analysis project is where you have to take the correlation tables from your articles into whatever platform you're using for meta-analysis. This can be a huge problem in articles with a huge correlation table, let's say with, for example, 20 variables, and it can take a lot of time to have them imported on your platform. That's why we have thought of ways to significantly reduce the time you need to import correlations from your article into the platform. Let's see how it works. Okay, so within HubMeta, I will open my project and go right into my data entry. We've talked about the general aspects of data entry in HubMeta. You can open any papers to start trying to enter data. I will start by creating a first sample. Okay, now that I have my sample here, I'm going to start importing correlational data here. Let's open the PDF for this file in a separate paper just to see where the correlation table is. Okay, it's down here, a 7x7. So basically, I have three main ways to enter this information into HubMeta. The first one is the manual way, in which you just add rows here and enter values directly from the PDF into the platform. And I talked about this in the previous video. The second and the more efficient way is trying to import from a CSV file, which you can edit in a spreadsheet program like Excel. So to do that, you would have to open this CSV. First of all, download a sample file from our platform and then open that into a spreadsheet program. So that's how it looks. Let's try a 3x3 correlation matrix just for an example. Let's enter some values here. And give some values for mean and standard deviation. And this is Cronbach alpha. So yeah, I'm happy. So let's just delete the rest of the stuff that we don't need. And then I will go ahead and save this file, then upload it on HubMeta, import. There we go. These are the values we just entered. There is, however, a third way of doing this, and that's reading it directly from the PDF, which is really cool. Let's see how it works. This time I'll go into info, and down here, I can see the PDF file for my article. So I will just scroll down to find where the correlation table is. There we go. So I click on enable capture. And the only thing I need to do is to just draw a rectangle around the actual correlation table. And when I release, it starts automatically reading it. And it gives the result as a CSV file. Let's open that CSV file in our spreadsheet program. That's how it looks. So what I will do at this point is I will just try to copy and paste these into that default CSV, which I downloaded from HubMeta. I want to repeat what we did in the last step. So let's paste these values here. I will have to move these variable names to the front, and let's make sure that I will expand this here. Yeah, I think we're good. Oh, okay. So for the mean and SD in this article, I have them here. Let's just copy them into uh, our CSV, which we are preparing for upload on HubMeta. Let's save this file. I don't have Chromebox Alpha. And let's go back to HubMeta and try to upload this file. Go back to correlations, import from CSV, and upload this file, import, and we're golden. You see, we even have the variable names and all the values we wanted. So you would agree with me that this can have significant time savings. Like, it took me about 2 minutes to enter this huge correlation table 7x7. If I wanted to do this manually, it would perhaps take me 15 to 20 minutes. So this can save a lot of time on your side. So make sure you test this feature with your papers and leave us a comment if you had any suggestions.